Look at all this. Holy crap. Oh no. Have I got 20Ks of this stuff to go? Are you serious? Nah, that's me done. All right, we're going back. G'day legends, we're back. We're back out in the bush on the 890. We're actually solo today. We've come to a place, the Olney State Forest. We're gonna go for the Watagans. If you remember back in the day with the Africa Twin, the very first off-road tour that I did was on the Africa Twin, and it was right here at the Watagans. So we're gonna go and explore the Watagans. So stick around. We're gonna go get in the dirt. If you haven't seen that video, click that little tab up there or check out the link below. We'll put that down there. And let's go see what this is like. This should be a lot of fun. Guess I'm not on my own. There we go. Bunch of KTM riders up behind me, but today it's about getting out, getting used to the 890. Really haven't had a good start, to be honest, have we? And that's why I thought we'd come back to where the first run was on the Africa Twin. The Watagans is just an absolutely stunning location to explore, so I thought we'll head out here and just go and suss it all out. And now I've got these lads coming up behind me as well. See how that goes. Wow, look at this. It's like being in a rainforest. Did you lose your mate?
Yeah, he did. I thought it was him. I fell on the wrong
boat. How are you, Brett?
Good, how are you?
Yeah, good, how are you?
Wrong,
dude. Yeah,
he was ahead of me, but he kept on going straight on.
Well, I thought of it, he went straight on.
That's what the dust was, I could see.
Well, that's what followed me, miss there, mate. They thought I was he. Didn't help that we're all on 890s or KTMs at least anyway. All right. Let's do this. Made it up here in good time. It's only 20 to 11. Bit of freeway activity. The 890 is pretty good on that freeway. Hit that cruise control. I know the people have said they don't like this short screen because of the wind, but I reminisce back to the day of having my SP1, my GSXR 750. That was all about getting the wind in your hair, so it's quite comfortable. Oh wow, okay. Bit of a nice spot. Fairly good way down. Beautiful and windy. Hell of a day. Well, that wind is certainly up. Ugh. Let's just have a quick look at the moment at the Garmin. So I've got this track running. Let's see, how's it looking? Track recorder. So, yeah, it looks like it's giving me the right time. So I'm happy with that. We'll keep that carrying on. I'll just turn that off to save the battery. Actually, how much battery do I have? That's coming down pretty quick. I'm really looking forward to wiring that thing in. All right, let's jump off here and we'll have a quick walk around. All right, legends, so we're at Monkey Face Lookout. Some specky views from the Watagans if you ever get out here, whether it be in your four-wheel drive or your bike, but definitely well worth coming and have a look. We'll go for a quick wander, meander through the cable or over the cable. There's a couple of walks that are around here, which are pretty nice. You can actually head down here a little bit, but these views are pretty spectacular. They're pretty amazing. And it's a long way down. Look at that. Gorgeous properties. Stunning views. Yep. So yeah, it's looking good so far. The 890 is doing very well. Slowly gaining more confidence on her, which is good. It's going to take a bit of time, but we'll get there. All we have to do is just keep doing our thing and rolling with it. The next WED 3, that's a nice lid. If you're looking for a new one, you want to get away from the standard old helmets, do that. It actually comes with its own action camera mounts. I'm trying out this clamp to see what it's like. I tell you right now, I'm not a fan, so I'm going to go back to Nex's very own action camera mounts because they just seem to be a lot better. They weigh a little less. Anyhow, we're going to carry on. We're going to move on, get back out, and go and explore some more. Go and have some lunch somewhere, I think. Sounds like a plan. Good to see that in rally mode, I've still got my ABS locked on road. Got the throttle set for off-road, and what I reckon we might do one day is go through the TFT, and I'll show you how that is all set up. Make sure I've left nothing behind and zips us up. Good. All right. Let's go. So I've learned some pretty hard lessons over the last few weeks, especially that first day out on the Kato with Mark. Locking up that rear brake, not holding the clutch in, keeping ABS off, that was silly. I'll let the pros do that. And I'll just stick with ABS on. No need for me to turn it off, not with my limited skill set. And go down to the bottom one first. This is Heaton Lookout. Pretty nice spot. I'll show you that on the way back. Because there's only one way around, really. Oh, that's right. These are the ones where the hang gliders, paragliders all launch from. Pretty cool, huh? We'll go further down, but we'll come up for a bit of a sticky beak on the way back. Nice being out here all alone. I'm enjoying it. Stroth, look at that. So that's the track that I'm not going down. Not my kind of thing. Let me stick it up here and we'll get a photo. Wow. What do you reckon? 1G Power Station, out to Swansea, Belmont, all the way to Newcastle. Beautiful spot, hey? Pretty good. We might stop here for a bit, open up the vents and the jacket, and chill out, have a bite to eat.
Well, g'day, legends. Been a nice day out at the Watagans, and having a bit of a run out here today, and I thought I've got the opportunity to sit down and have a chat. Had a lot of questions about the 890 here. You know, why I've done it. Can you see the lizard? The goanna popping out the back there. Got some company here tonight. How good is that? Yeah, so a lot of people have asked why the 890. Now, on paper, the 890 looked really good. I wanted something that's still comfortable for touring, good on range, you know, the 20-litre tank, but I did need something lighter. The 890 comes in dry at about 196 kilo. So weight-wise, that's a big benefit for me. I took a few bikes out, and that video, if you haven't seen it, it's already up there. You can have a look at that. I'd love to still take out, just for a comparison reason, things like the Norden 901, a T7, a T7 World Raid. What else was there? We did the Desert X. That was good fun. And just, you know, go and get a feel for some of these bikes. We've got some great dealers in Newcastle. I might even take that new, there's a CF Motos at the 800 that's coming out, which I'm pretty keen to have a look at as well. But yeah, look, the 890, everything I looked at, it just looked better on paper. Took it for a test ride and I'm pretty happy with the comfort level. Do feel today that I might need some risers on the handlebars and getting some lower back pain because I'm a little bit taller, around that 180 centimeters. So standing up is still comfy, but I just feel I need to be a little bit higher. Wow, where do you start? Other than that, changed the tires out. So I've got an Anarchy Wild sitting on the front. I've got the Motos Rules on the back, and that makes a big difference as well. The tech behind it and the TFT screen and the modes, we'll do a video separately on that and I'll run you guys through everything there. But the 890 kicked me off, and if you haven't seen that video and you want a good laugh, just click this link up here and I'll put it down below. I turned off ABS. Now, the feedback I've had from you guys, which is awesome, it's a big no-no. And on the day, I was, you know, perfectly straight ride, thought it should be good, you know, I'll test it out, see what it's like. I've come off the DCT, which we'll talk more about in a minute, but I tapped that brake, it locked up, and I felt okay with it. Then the bike stalled, so it stayed locked up. I've got more company here. I've got another lizard hanging around. Where is he? He's over the back. There's another one down here somewhere. So yeah, I locked up the back wheel. I didn't clutch, not used to the clutch. It's amazing how 2.5 years of being on the DCT of the Africa Twin can really change your riding style. I do feel like I've gone 10 steps back. Own it, straight up, my fault. Shouldn't have done it, but it did. And what a massive lesson to learn. So I've constantly, like, turning my brain back on to have one or two fingers on the clutch at the moment. And I need to do some training courses. I've never ridden an off-road style bike, an adventure bike, normal bike that's non-DCT. So I've got a lot to learn, and I think this journey is going to be pretty good, which is why we're out at the Watagans. It's the one place I bought the Africa Twin for its very first off-road run to get used to it, and I thought this is a really fitting place to give it a go. So the program today is just get used to it, but I do need some training courses, certainly do. So yeah. So coming off that DCT, wow, what a massive difference that's been. I actually didn't think it would have that big a difference. The first ADV style bike I bought in 2019 was the 2013 BMW R1200 GS. Funnily enough, I came up here as well, but I had road tires on it, so I didn't get very far without losing a lot of confidence. And since then, I didn't really take that thing off road. I was just really enjoying being on the road and doing the touring. But when I got the DCT, I think the reason I didn't drop the bike out in the bush is because it was a DCT. How's that? First off-road run that we have with Mark, Throttle Riding Adventures, and I've been up on the straightest road you could possibly find. That was a bit silly, wasn't it? Oh, well. You know, you learn these things. And look, you want to pay me out, go for it. Thank you for everyone who's given me the support. These things happen. But yeah, look, we've got a wicked journey ahead. I mean, I'm really enjoying this at the moment. KTM Newcastle, now known as Newcastle Power Sports. So all their links are updated. Make sure you go and check out their Instagram, their Facebook page, their YouTube, and of course their website. So Newcastle Power Sports, they've been awesome. They set up the bash plate for me. They got me the Acabus guards as well. That's been awesome. I need to say a massive, massive thanks to Nicole and Shannon. Anytime I've ordered something from Motorcycle Adventure Products, it has been so quick to get here. It's been awesome. We've got the Next Wed 3, the Carbon. This is the X-Pro Carbon. And as you can see down here, I've also got the X-Com, which is basically a center. That works an absolute treat. This is great for these warm days because the ventilation on this is just epic. It's outstanding. The front ventilation is so good, you get a bit too much wind noise in the microphone when I'm sitting there gas bagging to you guys. So that's been really good. Do like this, that little visor's been a lifesaver because I hate wearing sunglasses in a helmet. So that's pretty cool. You do need to clean it out a lot though, because you get mud in, not mud, but just dust in there, it can bugger it up. And this peak's pretty good. So this helmet's been awesome. The guys also sent me an Enduristan 4H tank bag, because I need some storage. And I'll tell you a bit in a minute about what we were talking about earlier with the storage that we're doing on the back of the bike. But I love this Enduristan tank bag. I think it's about 7 liters, totally waterproof. It fits everything that I've got for me today. I've got my batteries in there. I can plug them into the charger. So, you know, I've got the power cable connected in there. I've got my keys. I've carried lunch in there, my hat, sunnies, you name it. It's great. So that's been pretty cool. The next project, we're doing a customized plate for KTM 890s. And that customized plate will have the drill bits for the Krieger eyelets. So we're going to go a Krieger system on the back. But this plate will sit the Krieger US-30 on the back. And the US-30 will clip into the eyelets. And then I've got two OS 12s coming as well. And those 12s will attach to the US-30. So everything will be tight and secure, but the advantage is they're not going to hang down on the fairing. They're not going to hang down on the exhaust pipe. There's no risk of it getting too hot. And it's four eyelets. You take those off the US-30 and you can take all the bags with you. So that's not going to be too bad. What's that, 54 litres of storage there, plus the tank bag. Still got room. The other advantage for the plate is all the luggage goes further up the back, so I can still store the tent on the back seat as well. That's the plan. You know, everything's good in theory. At the moment, all I need to do is get used to this bloody thing. So we're working on that. We'll work on that pretty well. So yeah, that's where we're at the moment. It's a stunning day out. We're going to go and explore a little bit more of the Watagans. Stick around for that. And guys, I just want to say a massive thank you. We reached 5,500 subscribers. If you haven't subscribed, it is free. Just hit that subscribe button. If you want to know when I put a video out, hit the notification bell. That'll pop up and send you an email and let you know that I've sent one out. Massive thanks. You guys have been epic. And I just can't get over the comments that you've made, the support. It's been pretty good. You know, you guys are pretty solid. I was in a pretty crappy spot for that month after the accident, and still sorting that out. Sorry. Anyhow, if it wasn't for you guys and it wasn't for this, I don't know what I'd be doing. Thank you so much. Love you lots. Let's go riding. Anyone got a tissue? Damn it. Thanks, guys.
Harris Fire Trail. Where am I going? Is it this way? Or that way? Oh, look at this. There's beautiful parts of the world. Whoa! Hang on a minute. Well, that could be a problem. This could be an ish. Let's go and have a look. Well, maybe I will. Down there, up. Yeah, that'll be all right. Look at all this. Holy crap. All right, well, let's give it a shot. Up here. Up there. Into here. Woo! Let's hope we don't have to go back through that. It would not be fun, but if we have to, so be it. Very steep. Holy moly. That's real steep. Whew. Yeah, straight down the center. Got it. Straight in. Look at that. Oh. Righty-o. Now, down here expecting big puddles. We'll inspect. Oh, how badly chewed out is that? Not bad. Not bad at all. Oh, wow, look at this. Please tell me we're recording. Oh my God, yes. Woohoo. Lot of debris. Very mucky. Would not like to go back, but I can if I really need to. Pretty epic. Oh, another one. Well done, Kato. Oh, these water holes. Oh no. Have I got 20 k's of this stuff to go? Oh, it is not. Are you serious? Oh my, up we go. Oh. Yep, got it. That's why we got the bash plate. Nah, that's me done. All right, we're going back. Holy shit, no. All right, we got a bit of a journey now. Back we go. Damn it. All right, let's do it all over again. Actually, sit down here, let's have a break. Whew. All right, we're gonna have a break. All right, guys. Unfortunately, I didn't hit record because I was so nervous as to what's going on. So I'm just gonna make my way through, back through this bloody mud pile that I did earlier. I'm pretty nervous, but reasonably settled. I've got this big downhill. There's a number of obstacles coming up. So I got this to go down, and that is real steep. So I'm gonna stay over here, stay seated up the back. Nice and easy, gentle brake, gentle brake. I don't wanna stall it, so clutches in. Hell of a lot easier going down than it was up. Going up was all first gear fun. stay on the right. You see my tire tracks. Bit of momentum to get through there. And then I think I'll try and get through the middle. All right. Couple of water spots. We got plenty of fuel. That was probably the biggest challenge right there. I whacked a rock so hard going up that big hill. In the rut. Puddle. And I'm just going to have to go through it now. Oh, yucky. Oh, Mark, you'd be proud. Brendo Costa, I wish you were here, guys. The moral support would be awesome, but I've got you guys in my ear, so that's all good. Which way did I go here? Up through there. All right, let's try and do that again, shall we? Feet. I've still got this other challenge up here with the trees down, and that's going to be hard. That's going to be real hard. Oh, up we go. Up again. Turn that traction control off. All right, that's quite steep coming up. There it is. Go up that way. We are through. Yeah, baby. Well done, Kato. Well done. Outstanding. We'll sit up here and have a bit of a breather. Wow. 10 minutes. Yeah, wow. I would never have gotten through that in the twin, ever, to do that right now. Mind you, I would have turned around a lot earlier on the twin too. Kato, you and I are going to get along just fine. Oh, I am knackered. Oh, gate. What the f***? No way. No freaking way. Private property. No freaking way. Oh, my God. No, I'm not going through there. All right. Guess we're heading back. What a day, what a day. Okay, we'll follow the track back and let's head home. Oh dear, look at that. Yeah, that. Oh, cool. Mate, boys, you're going to be proud. You're going to be very proud. Look at that. What an absolute mess. It's time to go home. Let me just check. It's 10 to 3. It's been a pretty huge day. The bike is filthy. Check this rock. I hit a rock right there. Look at that. So, and we survived. I'm going to have a quick drink, put the plugs in, hit the freeway. Thank you so much for coming along. This was massive. I'm out of here. I'm exhausted. I'm knackered. This, I will say right now, I'm more fatigued than I would be on the twin. My hands are killing me. We'll come up with a solution for that later. But for now, I am gone. Going home. Uru for now, guys. Ride safe. Stay left.